Now, for more on this, Independent Women's Forum Director of Policy, Hadley Heath Manning. Hadley, welcome to the program.
Thank you.
You know, in particular, we talk about this default coming. I mean, it comes down to oil when it comes to Venezuela, and the world is cutting them off. The U.S. should likely probably be cutting them off. I mean, that could paralyze them, but we're not there yet. Why?
Well, they're already a paralyzed economy, and it's not just because of oil. It's because the government has managed the economy there. This is socialism 101. We've seen it fail over and over again. It's failing now because of problems inherent to socialism, not because this time around the government mismanaged things. And of course, President Maduro's response is, if you'll give us more power, then we can finally fix things. I think that's the wrong direction.
Yeah, but what does the world have, what can we do? I mean, that's the question. You know, we put these sanctions, the United States did, we announced those against Nicolas Maduro on his own assets. But there's no, you don't see any world leader. You see all these cries about he's a dictator, he's Bashar al-Assad, he's Kim Jong-un. But no one's willing to say we're willing to go in and assist the people of Venezuela. And this is a humanitarian crisis.
Right. Even though the Venezuelan government refuses to declare a state of humanitarian crisis, that's exactly what's happening. We have mothers digging through dumpsters looking for food for their babies in Venezuela due to food shortages. So absolutely. First of all, I commend this program for covering the topic. We haven't seen enough news media coverage of what's happening in Venezuela in the United States. And if Americans are really concerned, there are some humanitarian organizations on the ground, privately operated, some of them Catholic
yes.
charities, attempting to help people. But ultimately, the solution is going to have to come within a structural change in the Venezuelan government to limit the government's power and denationalize some of the industries like farms that have been taken over by the socialist government.
Well, and, you know, that's the thing, though. You've got opposition leaders, two of which were taken away in the middle of the night in their pajamas after this election, which is being called a sham worldwide, at least by the Western world, at least. So what could be done by the opposition? Do they have any power left? We see these protests, but the protests don't seem to have success. Maduro still is hanging on to power, and it's hard to understand why when you've got unrest like this that we're all witnessing on our television screens.
That's right. And to be clear, there have been some pressures from outside of Venezuela. For example, the United States has put into place personal sanctions against about 13 leaders inside of Venezuela, socialist side leaders, for example, revoking their visas. There have been personal sanctions against Maduro. But any further you know, efforts within the country on the opposition side, right now I understand they're protesting. They're trying to prevent this new assembly from taking place. And obviously the world is watching as the mm-hmm. crisis unfolds there.
You know, I hate to say that you want to find a great forensic accountant at this point, but you do to find where all the money went, those billions of dollars in oil revenues that have obviously been stolen from the Venezuelan people.
And it's an important issue for Americans to watch and to study, because there's an alarming trend. You know, 53% of young American adults say they have a favorable attitude towards socialism. That's troubling when we see yeah. every time socialism has been tried, it has failed, and it results in poverty and it results in starvation and death.
Agreed. 100%, Hadley. Thank you very much for being here.